Hello, Pato. Oh, I'm sorry. You'd like some peace and quiet, am I right? Well then, I'll be absolutely sure to... Ah. Right. Quiet. Ooh, a new mobile phone. It looks really cool. What do you plan to do with it? The first thing to do is to choose a good ringtone. Very catchy. It looks like you're not the only one who likes your ringtone, Pato. There, that's done it. Alone again. Ah, a nice quiet stroll alone. It's Elly calling. Oh, I see. Elly called you because she wanted your phone to make that ringtone again. Well, I can't say I blame her. It's Pocoyo. He must want to hear that. Oh, Pato, do come back. That song is just so catchy. You've set your phone to vibrate, which means you won't be bothered by anyone anymore. I suppose that makes sense. Look, all your friends are here. Why don't you put your phone down and go join them? Pato! Your phone! No one's calling? That's strange. No one again? Then where's that buzzing sound coming from? Oh, it's just sleepy birds snoring. Looks like it was a false alarm. Oh, I'm sorry, Pato. All the cake is gone. But there are plenty of carrot sticks. Pato, what is that you're playing on your phone? Well, that seems fun. But wouldn't you have more fun playing with your friends? No, don't throw it in the lake. Pato, it looks like Fred needs your phone. That's all right, isn't it? Why, it looks like he ordered a pizza. And Ellie's texted all your friends. There's that catchy tune. Isn't it wonderful, Pato? A dance party with pizza. What fun! Goodbye, everybody. Hello, Elly. Making a nice cup of tea? Oh, dear. That won't do. Good morning, Pocoyo. Ah, bath time. Aren't you forgetting something? Your water's gone bad too. Hello, Pato. Oh, do be careful. Your water has a rather icky color too. Pato? Something must be done about this nasty water straight away. Very good. You should follow the water pipe to the start. The water in this pond simply must be cleaned up. That poor fish! Oh, we should help him. done, Elly. Very good, Pocoyo. You certainly are collecting lots of rubbish. Wonderful, Pato. This pond will be clean in no time. Job, everyone! But I'm afraid the water is still brown. Well done, every one of you. Well done indeed. Ah, what a perfect morning on the nice, clean pond. And it's all thanks to all your hard work, guys. Hello, everyone.
Hi.
That looks like a fun game of football you're playing. What a great goal! Hello, Nina.
Hi.
Hello, Roberto. Would you like to play football too? What's that? You have a much more fun game at home? More fun than football? Nina wonders if you'd like to try her game. Why don't you run and get your game, Nina? Nina was wondering if you'd please mind her pet robot until she returns.
Yeah!
great idea, Pato. Roberto can be goalie till Nina returns. Roberto, you must stop the ball. Oh dear. Are you all right? Oh my. Roberto looks like a toaster. He is a toaster. Oh dear. Are you all right? Now you're a robot vacuum. Well, that's handy. What with all this toast lying around. Caterpillar, baby bird, watch out! Pocoyo, phew! You've saved Caterpillar and baby bird. Very good. Roberto, be careful! Huh! It turns out you're a wonderful dancer! Oh no! He's out of control! You have to stop him! Nina! Quick! No one can shut Roberto down! You must know a way! Nina brought something for you all to play with. What fun! Hello, Pato. What a lovely day to care for your plants. Oh dear. Pato, it seems someone shut the water off. What was that? Pato. Pato, please slow down a bit. You say you saw a little green creature like this one? Says her name is Nina. Why not introduce yourself, Pocoyo?
Pocoyo.
And this is Roberto. Hello, Nina and Roberto. It seems she's never shaken hands before. An umbrella? But it's not raining. So, you've seen Pato before. You were playing with your friend the ladybug, and Pato came. He watered the plant, and you got all wet. Oh, but Nina, I'm quite sure Pato didn't mean to get you wet. Pato was just watering his plants to help them grow. Yes, because he loves plants more than almost anything. She says that anyone who loves plants deserves a hug. Oh, I see. That's to warn Nina whenever Pato waters the plants. Brilliant! This calls for a celebration. Roberto, would you? Pocoyo and Elly and Pato.
Hi!
What's that you're playing?
Marbles.
Let's see. You need to get your marble into that small hole right there in the middle, right? And how is everyone doing? What about you, Pocoyo? That's a special black super marble. Oh, I'm sorry, Pocoyo. You almost had it. Well, whose turn is it now? Wait! What's happening? Yes, Pocoyo, but how did your marble move all on its own? I think you've discovered a black hole. It'll suck up anything nearby. And you know what that means, don't you? Pocoyo, this is no time for dancing. Now come on, get away from that hole. Good idea, Pato. Grab that tree. Hold on, everyone. This is rather funny, isn't it? But I'm afraid we have to get Elly out somehow. Can anyone switch on the light? Well, that's a relief. Everything seems to be fine, except for one minor detail. All the colors are reversed. Pato, you're not yellow anymore. Now you're purple. And Elly, now you're green. You'd like everything to go back to normal, wouldn't you? Well, maybe there's a way. Are you thinking about how to get back to your world, Pocoyo? Well, you know, maybe your black super marble is the key. Maybe it can take you back home. Yes, Elly, that's That's it. In this world, Pocoyo's black marble would be white. Now what? There you go, a white hole. Jump in, everyone. But Pato, don't you want to be yellow again? This certainly isn't your world. You're all made of paper. You'd better find that marble. Good job, Pato. Oh my. You're balloons now. Phew. You're back home, guys. You didn't leave anything behind, did you? That's a good question, Pato. What should you do with it? It looks like Pocoyo has an idea. A rocket? Oh, I see. Well, then I'd better start a countdown. Ready?
3, 2, 1, blast!
Well, look at that. It's a magical nighttime. See you soon. Morning, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Going for a walk, I see. Chicken eggs. How curious. I wonder where their mother's gone. How wonderful! But still no mother. You'd better take care of these chicks until she returns. Do you think you can do it?
Yes! Pocoyo takes care!
You'd better follow them, Pocoyo. Maybe it's time to teach them to roost. Very good. Looks like you could use some help, Pocoyo. Maybe Pato?
No, Pato. Elly, help Pocoyo.
Elly? I bet she'd make a wonderful mother. Elly, will you help Pocoyo mind these chicks? This is curious. Looks like someone's got those chicks in line. But who?
It's Pato!
What a surprise! You make a better mother hen than we thought. Amazing! You've done it! What's next, Pato? Flying! But chickens don't fly. Unbelievable! You're a natural with these chicks. Well, you're just full of surprises, Pato. What could possibly be next? Oh no, Pato. What happened to your flock of chicks? Oh! Their mothers found them at last. Well, of course, the chicks belong with their mother. Oh dear. Perhaps some rest will do you good. There we are, Pato. Get a good night's rest. Well, it looks like you've made new friends for good. Lovely. Good night, Pato. And good night to all. Hello, Pato. Oh, I'm sorry. You'd like some peace and quiet, am I right? Well then, I'll be absolutely sure to... Ah. Right, quiet. Ooh, a new mobile phone. It looks really cool. What do you plan to do with it? The first thing to do is to choose a good ringtone. Very catchy. It looks like you're not the only one who likes your ringtone, Pato. There, that's done it. Alone again. Ah, a nice, quiet stroll alone. It's Elly calling. Oh, I see. Elly called you because she wanted your phone to make that ringtone again. Well, I can't say I blame her. It's Pocoyo. He must want to hear that. Oh, Pato, do come back. That song is just so catchy. You've set your phone to vibrate, which means you won't be bothered by anyone anymore. I suppose that makes sense. Look, all your friends are here. Why don't you put your phone down and go join them? Pato! Your phone! No one's calling? That's strange. No one again? Then where's that buzzing sound coming from? Oh, it's just sleepy birds snoring. Looks like it was a false alarm. Oh, I'm sorry, Pato. All the cake is gone. But there are plenty of carrot sticks. Pato, what is that you're playing on your phone? Well, that seems fun. But wouldn't you have more fun playing with your friends? No, don't throw it in the lake. Pato, it looks like Fred needs your phone. That's all right, isn't it? Why, it looks like he ordered a pizza. And Ellie's texted all your friends. There's that catchy tune. Isn't it wonderful, Pato? A dance party with pizza. What fun! Goodbye, everybody. Hello, Elly. Making a nice cup of tea? Oh, dear. That won't do. Good morning, Pocoyo. Ah, bath time. Aren't you forgetting something? Your water's gone bad too. Hello, Pato. Oh, do be careful. Your water has a rather icky color too. Pato? Something must be done about this nasty water straight away. Very good. You should follow the water pipe to the start. The water in this pond simply must be cleaned up. That poor fish. Oh, we should help him. Done, Elly. Very good, Pocoyo. You certainly are collecting lots of rubbish. Wow! Wonderful, Pato. This pond will be clean in no time. Job, everyone! But I'm afraid the water is still brown. Well done, every one of you. Well done indeed. Ah, what a perfect morning on the nice, clean pond. And it's all thanks to all your hard work, guys.